Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, here to tell you what's in the movies this weekend. But first, to answer some of your mail. I asked you last week, really, about all those horrible 1980s movie remakes. You know I hated Footloose, and it didn't even get to be number one. They spent like $50 million, and you know it made 15. No, wrong. The thing just disappeared out of sight. But I said, what do you guys really want? And here's a few answers, and some of them I think are really great. Now, there was a lot of argument about The Breakfast Club remaking it. Now, I'm saying, wasn't anything really wrong with The Breakfast Club as far as I could see? But I want to know from you, then, who's going to be Molly Ringwald? Who's going to be Emilio Estevez? Who's going to be Judd Nelson, Ally Sheedy, and especially Anthony Michael Hall? And with John Hughes dead, who is going to direct it? You tell me that, and then I'm going to call Hollywood about it. One I really loved was someone named Ricardo who said, remake Bonfire of the Vanities. What a great idea. That sucked. It was a good director, Brian De Palma, and he couldn't really make a good job of it. So who should? I think that was a really good idea. Then somebody, Andrew, said, let's do a remake of Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer, which had a guy named Michael Rooker in it, and he's saying, get the guy who plays Bane in the new Dark Knight Rises movie. Well, that guy's Tom Hardy, who's in it. I think that might be good, too. I think that's okay. And, you know, Ryan says, in all seriousness, I think someone like J.J. Abrams could make a good Dune remake because David Lynch, who rarely screws up, screwed up in that one. My favorite one here, though, however, is Vito. And he says, remake Ghostbusters because Bill Murray, I'm going to get his exact words here, I didn't really like Bill Murray's performance in it. Don't understand that. But I have to commend Vito because he also said, put Peter Travers in the scum bucket. So, whoa. You know, suck me up, hit me, put me in. I'm ready to be shrunken down and put in it. You know, you guys are right. What can I say? Sometimes I deserve to be in it. All right. That's over. Now, what's out in the movies? It's two young actresses who are going to explode. They both had movies at Sundance. I'm going to start with Elizabeth Olsen, who's in a movie called Martha, Marcy May, Marlene. What does that mean? She's in a cult, and she escapes from a cult, and her real name is Martha. The cult leader, played by Teardrop, otherwise known as John Hawks, who was nominated for an Oscar last year for playing Teardrop in Winter's Bone. He's the cult leader, and he gets these girls, he kind of rapes them, you know, and then they can't eat with him, the men have to eat first. But what happens with Elizabeth Olsen's character is she escapes, she runs away, and she finds her sister and her sister's husband, and she says, can I come live with you? She never tells them what happened to her 2 years in that cult, and we see it in the face. Elizabeth Olsen is the younger sister of Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, those tycoons of the industry. And is somebody that you can't take your eyes off on screen. She's amazing. Okay, who's the other one? This is Felicity Jones, who's in a movie called Like Crazy, which is a love story about a girl, a British girl, an exchange student in a college in LA, falls in love with another student, Anton Yelchin, and overstays her visa. When she goes back to London, she is stuck there. She can't come back to America. How do you deal with a long-distance relationship? It sounds like something awful. It sounds like that awful Drew Barrymore movie, Going the Distance. But it's not, because this director, a young director named Drake Doremus, he directs this in a way you can't believe. It's just inventive, crazily inventive, I'll even say. And looking at the face of Felicity Jones, you just look and say, play everything. I want you to be in every movie out there. She is tremendous. Both of these actresses could get Oscar nominations if Hollywood doesn't get stuck in the same Meryl Streep rut that they're in constantly. But my question to all of you out there is, when you see these two movies, you can tell me whether you like them or not, but also, who do you remember as a great debut performance? I mean, I'm thinking immediately of Jennifer Lawrence last year in Winter's Bone. I mean, that was an incredible debut in a starring role. Come on, you know? Yeah. That didn't seem like much enthusiasm out there. But what about Natalie Portman when she was in The Professional? You know, when she was an assassin? You know? Who else is out there? Some people in this room I know think Justin Bieber in his documentary.
Bieber!
So go from Bieber to Jennifer Lawrence, I don't care, but I want to hear. Who was somebody you saw out there that you thought gave a great debut performance? And I'm Peter Travers, and I'm now going to retreat to my scum bucket.